Yes, I'm going to walk. Oh, that milky white way. Oh, child, some of these days. Well, I'm going to walk that milky white way. Oh, some of these days. Well, 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 I'm going to walk up and take up my stand. Gonna join that Christian band. I'm going to walk, whoa, that milky white way. Oh, Lord, some of these days. I'm gonna tell my, oh, my mother, howdy, 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 when I get home. Yes, I'm going to tell my mother howdy when I get home. Well, 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 I want to tell my mother hey when I shake mother hand that day. That's when I won't. Oh, that milky white way. Some of these days. I want to meet.
He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. is the King of glory.
Behold, I show you under his
in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last drop. For the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible. Shall be changed. For this corruptible must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. So when this corruptible shall have put on incorruption, and this mortal shall have put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. Oh, death, where is thy sting? Thank you. Genesis. As we come now to the homegoing service of our little brother, Mr. C. Brown. The family have provided us all the service. And my understanding is, if your name is not on the program, today is not your day to get up. But days, weeks, and months after all this is over, Sister Brian is going to need somebody to come by and talk to her then. And if you just have to have something to say, I invite you to stop by our house, sit down and have a conversation with her. Our prayer going to be led today by Deacon Charlie Stewart. Scripture reading in the Old Testament, Pastor Calvin James. New Testament, Pastor Alvin Haslip. Musical selection, Sister Dorothy McCray. Selected scripture, Pastor Calvin James. Mr. River read it solemnly. Our hymn going to be by his pastor, Pastor Terrell Carter, and the eulogy going to follow the hymn by Pastor Carter. At this time, our deacon is coming for prayer.
Our Father,
yes.
Our Heavenly Father. Father, we come this morning and say thank you. Thank you, Father, for giving us another opportunity. And we realize it was nobody but you that gave us this opportunity. And now, Lord, we ask you to look over this family, Lord. Hold that hand. Lord, let them know that you don't make no mistakes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Oh, Heavenly Father, let them know that everything is going to be all right. But now, Father, if you look, Father, the blind will be able to see. If you look, Father, the lame will be able to walk. If you look, Father, everything will be all right. And now, Lord, look down on this family, Lord. Somebody is calling your name, Lord. It's calling you right now, Lord. Somebody's sick this morning. Somebody don't even know your name. But, Lord, we ask you to look down on them this morning. Hold them in the power of your hand. Because we realize that power lies in your word, Father. That's power to bring the lost back home. That's power to bring the family back together again. And that's power to walk away all unsigned tears, Lord. Oh, Lord, we ask you to look over them this morning. We realize, oh, Heavenly Father, that one day, that awesome day will come sooner or later. But now, oh, Heavenly Father, we stand at the altar this morning calling your holy name, Jesus. But oh Lord, we said you call on your name, you said come and that every knee shall bow. Amen. So we call it on your name this morning. There's no one else, Father, can do us like you can. But oh Heavenly Father, let this family put them together like a link of change, Lord. So when trouble come around, Lord, that we all mend it together, Lord. We know you the heart fixer. We know as trouble come and trouble go. But we know who our doctor is. So we call it on you this morning. To hold the hand this morning. Let them know, Heavenly Father, that one day it's going to be our time. One day we can help them coming, Lord. Because when that call comes and that time comes, Lord, we ask you, Father, give us a place where we can come and rest all our souls, Father. That when we rest, Father, there will be no more killing over there. There will be no more running from here to there. But, oh, Heavenly Father, we ask you this morning. Oh, Lord, hold our hand this morning. And, Lord, you know the tears are dropping this morning. But we realize you're the doctor. Doctor of all tears. The doctor that will bring joy. The doctor that will bring us together once again. The doctor that will cure all of our aches and pains. But oh, Heavenly Father, we said thank you for this opportunity. Because we realize it might just be the last opportunity. But oh, Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day. With you, well, we have been wrong. But Lord, we thank you. I don't know about y'all, but I got to say thank you. Because ain't nobody else can do me right. Thank you.
Be the good times. Let the dying time
Be the good time. Hold them. Oh, Lord, hold them. Link them together. But we thank you for bringing us together one more time.
Yeah.
We thank you.
Thank
you. While we in our right mind,
yeah,
while the blood is running warm, yes, and he's obeying
you.
Oh, have mercy on all of us. Lord, we need you.
Yes.
The way time is this.
Yes.
Lord, we ask you to meet with us. We need you right now.
Yes,
this family needs you. Need you right now. Oh Lord, when they don't know what you're going to do, we ask you, Father, to step in. You already know, Father.
Yes.
But Lord, let them know, Father. You're right by, I'm sitting there right there with them right now, Lord.
Yes.
We ask you to just talk. And Lord, we say thank you.
When my father and my mother forsake me,
then the Lord will take me up. I have read unto you Psalm 27, 1 through 10. May God have a blessing to the hearers, the reader of his holy word, and edification of our soul.
Thank you. this time, the family had asked me to read a selected scripture for someone. She had first asked me to speak as being a neighbor. And we was a neighbor for 44 years. And there wasn't much I could say about it. Brother Brown as a neighbor. No morning, he went away. He came home. He took care of children. Took care of family. He loved his wife. He loved his children. And they raised up two lovely sons.
Amen.
That is so memorable. And I feel like they my sons. Because whatever I can do for them. And they know, Terrell know that he can call me at any time. Or come by and talk to me at any time. Amen. My door is always open. We're going to read this scripture. Because we all have sinned. We need to come short to the glory of God. But Jesus gave us a chance for repentance. And when we repent, he remembers it no more. David realized that he had fell short.
Yes, yes.
He didn't try to blame the church that he went to. He didn't try to blame his neighbor. David went to the Lord and said, Lord, have mercy on me. O God, according to thy lovely kindness, according unto thy multitude of tender mercy. David said, blot out my transgression. That ever, that tells me that David knew he had done some wrong. He said, wash me thoroughly from my iniquity and clean me from my sin. Listen to what David said. For I acknowledge. And whenever you acknowledge your sin, my God can do something for you. He waited on you. For I acknowledge my transgression, and my sin is even before me. Again, against thee only have I sinned and done this evil in thy sight, that thou mightest be justified when thou speakest, and be cleansed when thou judgest. Behold, I was shaped in iniquity, and in sin did my mother conceive me. Behold, thou desire truth in the inward parts, and in the hidden part thou shalt make me to know wisdom. Purge me with hyssop, and I shall be clean. Watch me, and I shall be whiter than snow. Make me to hear joy and gladness, that thy bone which thou hast broken may rejoice. Listen what David said. Hide me. Hide thy face from my sin. And blot out all my iniquity. He said, create in me. See, David wasn't worried about you. He wasn't worried about his name. But David was worried about himself. He said, create in me a clean heart. And, oh God, and renew a right spirit within me. Listen to what he said. Cast me not away from thy presence, and take not the Holy Spirit from me. David wanted to feel the joy of his salvation again. Every now and then you want to feel that. So David said, restore unto me the joy of my salvation, and uphold me with thy free spirit. I have read unto you Amen. From Psalm 51, 1 through 20. May God have a blessing to the hearers and to the hearers of his holy word. And let it be for the edification of our soul. We hope these words will bless this bereaved family.
Amen.
Celebration, but yet another worship experience.
Come on. Yes, sir.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And the hymnologist says that the day.
Yes,
past and gone. The evening shade. Yeah. We lay our garments. didn't bother nobody.
That's right.
He minded his own business.
That's right.
That's what I know.
Yes, sir.
But irregardless of that, Job says in chapter 14 and verse number 1, man that's born of a woman is all a few days and full of trouble. And just for a few minutes, I'm going to talk from the subject. I'm so glad. Trouble.
Church. Yes, sir.
I don't care how long you've been righteous and holy. Don't care how long you did what you thought everything was right. None of us are exempt from trouble.
Yes, sir.
Because out of all the chaos that's going around, all of the struggles and the troubles in the air.
nothing can get in. And nothing can get out. He said, now I want to watch this. He said, I ain't got all the power. I only got what you give me. He said, but I promise you, if you move your hand and take the head from the rock and then let me have
it. Yes,
when you move your hand, let it fall in mine. I promise you, God, I'll make him curse you to your face. Watch God be bold, bodacious, having the audacity to look at Satan and say everything he got is in your hand. But what you got, you can have it. But you can't touch your soul. Because you didn't give life. And you can't take it. Yeah. Therefore, let's stop blaming death on Satan.
Yes, sir.
Satan has admitted.
Yes, sir.
In chapter 2, he can only do what God allows
him to do. Yes, sir.
Yeah. So you know the story, I ain't got time to tell it all to you, but you know the story how Satan takes all of his livestock, kills all of his animals, then he causes the whirlwind to come, and he killed Job's 7 sons and 3 daughters. Watch this. They wasn't bothering about it. The record says, enjoying themselves. What are you saying, preacher? You can be at home minding your own business. Then all of a sudden, servant said, Satan, you ought to stop with your bad self. He goes to Job and said, listen, all your children are now dead. I'm the only one that we're able to escape. Come and tell you all day. It ain't Job that you got to worry about. But the problem comes with Miss Job. The part I know it would be beneficial. But can you imagine her coming to call you and going to take every week and fill the hole? He is suffering from what they call bubonic plague.
Looks at her.
Yes, sir.
of a burden.
Yes, yes.
But I tell you, you got to learn how to hold on it. Be strong and let God, Mother Brown, fight all of your battles.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
See, folks are going to be hanging around today, the rest of the evening. But next week, when the cakes and pies stop coming, and the chickens stop being fried,
Thank you.
It's turning around for me. Yeah. lies, but yet it is true, that the battle for God's prize must go on without you. But you finished your task the other day, you folded up your tent and you went away. You left us, yes, you left us, and while you cannot come back to us, we are glad we can come to you. For the record will show that you died the other day, but from the record will show you're just away. The veterans of the United States Marine Corps veteran, Mr. Faith Brown, is most appreciative for the many kind and loving expressions of sympathy that you each have shown. They ask for your continued prayer in the days to come and may each of you continue to listen to the Lord. The following four arrangements have been sent to the family. Sending these with love, Lynn. With heartfelt sympathy, wishing you peace and comfort in the midst of your sorrow, love your church family. Leslie, Georgia, Reverend E. Terrell Carter, pastor. With your sympathy, Dawson Maynard. The family flower is given in loving memory of a loving and caring husband, father, grandfather, brother, and friend from the family. In loving memory of Dr. Tony Williams, Deacon Arthur L. Parker, CEO and president, along with staff of J.W. Williams Funeral Home, is pleased to present to this family an African-American family heirloom Bible, in the hope that it will serve as a source of added comfort and peace in the days to come. We are also pleased to present this family to enjoy the tribute of your loved one's life. It is our prayer that you forever remember the many cherished memories.